So, hi, what's up? It's your boy Sports Wizard, and welcome back to another video on my channel. So, today we're doing Djokovic vs. Zverev ATP final semifinal. So, let's jump right into it. So, my prediction Djokovic in 3 score on 6-3, 5-7, 7-6 mode with one. Easy. Mode hard. So, yeah, I mean, Djokovic, I think, will come out on top. Zverev is playing well, but I think Djokovic is just gonna, you know, play better and win. And yeah, let's come to the annotation. So Zverev went to the US Open final, also ended up in semifinals, won Grand Slam semifinals in Wimbledon fourth round. He has 17 titles, he's number 3 in the world. He won the ATP Tour finals, he won the Olympics, he won Cincinnati Open earlier this year. He has a good forehand, he has solid serve, but it's also not consistent. He has one of the best backhands on tour. He has a decent forehand. He's not a great mover, but he can still reach balls. And he's a baseliner. And whereas Djokovic has 20 Grand Slams, 85 titles, won all of the Masters 1000s at least twice. He won all of the Grand Slams at least twice. He's currently number 1 in the world. He's an aggressive baseliner. He has good ground strokes. He has the best back on tour, arguably. He has a good serve that's flat. He's a good returner. He's good in the crucial moments. He's also good at coming back and playing under pressure. He's a good mover. He can do both offense and defense. He does not have a good smash. His temper can cause problems. And he maybe takes the ball a little too early. He won Wimbledon 5 times, US Open 3 times, Austin Open 9 times, French Open twice. He won the Olympic bronze medal. He has 5 ATP Tour Finals wins. That was a 7-3 Djokovic on hard, 6-2 Djokovic, and in ATP Finals, it's 1-1. 1-1. That's one apiece just means 1-1. So, yeah, in the first set, Djokovic, he's going to go aggressive. He's going to hit winner's head aces, make Zverev move around. Well, Zverev, you know, he's not going to really be able to, like, run to get Djokovic's balls. And even if he does, like, you know, somehow manage to get there, Djokovic's balls will be way too powerful for, you know, like, almost anyone to return. So, you know, Djokovic will get points like that. And, you know, he's going to have good production. You know, like, he's going to hit winners and hit aces. Whereas Zverev, you know, he's still going to hit winners with his backhand, and he's still going to hit aces. But I think the aces to double faults kind of not going to be too great, because I think Zverev will hit quite a few double faults in the first set. And eventually, Djokovic will win the first set. In the second set, I think that's where Zverev takes control. You know, he fixes his serve, so he hits more aces, and he takes control. You know, he's the one that makes Djokovic move around. He hits powerfully as well, you know. And the thing is that he's going to make Djokovic try to come, like, really close to the net. So he's going to also try to hit a lot of drop shots, because, you know, Djokovic, he does not have the best net game. Let's just say that. So Zverev is going to try to aim to do that and get some points. Whereas Djokovic, you know, in the second set, he'll still hit some winners and aces. But it's going to be tough for him to move around and, you know, return Zverev's balls, because Zverev is going to be making Djokovic, like, move all around the place in the second set. So eventually, you know, Zverev will win the second set. In the third set, you know, they're both going to be hitting winners, hitting aces, making each other move around, you know, rallying with each other, you know, hitting powerful shots. And Zverev is going to try to make Djokovic come to the net. Whereas Djokovic, he's going to try to be doing the same thing. He's going to try to make Zverev come to the net. So if you guys are watching, there's a reason why there'll be a lot of net points. And there, I think there will be a lot of points at the net. So they're going to be getting points like that. But in the tiebreak, I think Djokovic, you know, he's just going to be too good. You know, he has the experience, you know, in the tiebreaks. And, you know, he's good. Like, under pressure, Djokovic is fantastic. So he's just going to be a little bit better. Like, I mean, I think Zverev will be a little bit tired as well. And Djokovic, you know, he's just going to be the one that's better in the crucial moments. Because I think Zverev in some very crucial moments, you know, he might hit some unforced errors or some double faults. Whereas Djokovic, you know, he's going to be maintaining well, you know, hitting aces, hitting winners, you know. At least putting the ball in the court. And I think that's going to be the difference, you know, the double faults and aces count. And I think that's why Zverev will lose this match and Djokovic will come out on top. So just for a quick recap, in the first set, Djokovic, you know, he's going to be going aggressive, he's going to hit winners, hit aces, make Zverev move around, make Zverev come to the net, hit a lot of drop shots, you know, maybe do a few serve and volleys, whereas Zverev, you know, he's still going to be hitting winners and aces, but it's going to be tough for him to, like, move around and return Djokovic's balls, and also, you know, his serve might be a little bit off point. And, you know, that's what he's going to be doing in the first set. In the second set, Zverev, he's going to go aggressive. He's going to hit Wurm City Aces, make Djokovic move around, you know, make Djokovic come to the net, rally with him. He's just going to be doing what basically Djokovic did to him in the first set and the second. Like, he's just going to be doing what Djokovic did to him in the first set. And Zverev will be doing the exact same thing in the second set. So he's just going to, you know, be copying what Djokovic did in the first set, basically. Like, giving him a taste of his own medicine. And in the second set, I think Djokovic will do better in the second set than Zverev will in the first set. So I think, like, Djokovic will still have some production, but he's going to have to move around a lot, you know. And if you try to hit winners while you're moving around a lot, it's going to result in unforced errors. In the third set, you know, both of them are gonna be playing, like, really well. But in the more crucial moments, I think Djokovic will be the one that's going to be slightly better, you know. Zverev might hit a few unforced errors and all that. So eventually Djokovic will come out on top. So yeah, guys, please make sure to like, subscribe, and turn on those notifications. Guys, 98% of you guys that watch are not subscribed. Yeah, you got like 98% of you guys that watch are not subscribed. So hit that subscribe button, guys. Please, can you make me happy? Like, hit that subscribe button. Let's get that number to as low as we can. And I guess, like I said, please make sure to like, subscribe, and turn on those notifications. Guys, like, after Medvedev and Sinner's match, there will be another semifinals matchup. So whenever that matchup comes out, I'll do a video, and stay tuned for that. And I guess, like, subscribe, and turn on those notifications. And I'll see you next time. Peace.